Hello everybody, my name is Uber and I welcome back in Dying Light. Now I am recording this episode right after I finish Bozakhord, so the previous episode that you probably have seen already. If you haven't seen it, maybe please watch it, because I spent quite a lot of time doing that, digging quite deep into what you can do, what you cannot do, and so on. But yeah, right now we are back in the normal game, and I would like to show you something. Something very, very interesting. So, if you played Dying Light, or maybe you watched it, something like that, then you probably know that drops or disaster self-reliable, what are they called? Disaster on location self-relief packages, something like that. It doesn't really matter. Basically, they are quite a good source of experience, right? That's quite true, right? What the fuck has happened? So it is also no surprise that you can get them quite easily. You can just run around the old town and it's very easy to find them. Like, you've got no problem with that. So right now I've got 32 disaster relief on-site packages. That's what they called. Nice. So that should give us quite a lot of experience. On normal difficulty you get around 11,000, something like that, for one. So you can calculate how much experience we will get for that, right? Right now we are at legend level 7. As you can see, we are already halfway to the next level, something like that. We can also distribute our points somewhere. It doesn't really matter. But yeah, take a look at how high we are at the levels. Okie dokie. And right now let's go to Quartermaster, because I am about to show you something absolutely crazy. I don't know if that is, I can call it cheating, exploiting, or just fun way to use the game mechanics, something like that. Let's go to Quartermaster, let's deliver that drop.
You got something for us? Thanks a lot. Every little thing matters.
And as you can see, we are already at legend level 11. Fucking 11. Yeah, that's crazy. So let's already distribute those points. I think that I want to go with that. After that I might go with health, I think. Or maybe with bow. Okie dokie, let's also get... We've got few dockets, I would like to also get them today. Let's go with bow. Let's get all the shit that probably we don't need right now. Okie dokie, so big question, how I did that? And it's pretty easy to figure out. So... if you are delivering drops, there are only two things that matter with them. First of all, it matters on what level you are, and we are talking about... Fuck, you already have seen what I'm talking about. The amount of survival levels that you are that you have is directly compare it to amount of experience that you're getting from drops. So at survival level 25, you are, for each drop you are getting 11,000 on normal difficulty. But if you switch to nightmare difficulty, as you can see right here, current session nightmare, you are getting, I don't even remember, I calculated that, but such a crazy amount of experience that is just amazing. Now, what if I told you that all of those drops that I collected, so 32 drops, I collected on normal difficulty. Then I get out of the game, pick up, you know, high difficulty, nightmare one, and then I'm going back in, delivering those drops to the quartermaster, and I have all the levels that I can get. Like, that is just crazy, right? It's so fucking broken. But yeah, probably those drops that you are giving when you are on nightmare difficulty are worth more, because it's not on nightmare difficulty, it's a lot higher, right? For example, on normal difficulty you will right now die when you've got legend levels. So you went all the way with survival rank, you are not losing any experience on survival rank or legend level even when you die on normal difficulty, but on nightmare, if you will die, you are losing quite a lot. So that's very, very shitty. So that's why you can see that I distributed only 10 points, but I got 11 legend levels. This is why, because I was when I was trying to figure out how those drops work on different difficulties, I died when I was on nightmare difficulty and lost quite a lot of levels, and also I lost one legend level. I mean, one point that we can distribute. So that was pretty shitty. Okie dokie. So just for the comparison, let me hop back to normal mode and I will show you how much experience we are getting for one drop. And then we'll hop back to nightmare difficulty. I will show you how much experience we are getting for one drop on nightmare difficulty. So hear you in just a moment. Okie dokie, I am back and change of plans, we are at nightmare difficulty because I wanted to check out how much experience we are getting from one drop on nightmare difficulty. And yeah, pro tip, if you are playing, go to this location, that's like, I don't know, randomly, once per day, no, I think it's once per few days. Drops in this location, that one drop, is respawning. Not constantly. You need about 3 in-game days, something like that. It doesn't really matter, but from time to time, just go here. Of course, it's quite easier to farm drops in Old Town, but yeah. Here you can get quite an easy drop, because you are in water, no zombies can get close to you. And so on. So yeah, that's pretty amazing location for getting a free drop almost. So yeah, go here as often as you can. And as I said, it's not like every single day or something like that. I believe that every 3 days or something like that, it's respawning. Something like that. It doesn't matter on how high level you are, or if you finish the game, or if you are at a certain point of the game that no more drops are dropping in slums. It doesn't really matter. You can just come here as much as you want. But not always that is there. Okie dokie, let's see. I would like to see how much experience we'll get. So right now we are at 800,000. Okie dokie. Let's deliver the drop. Thank you very much. So we gained. Okie dokie. I will put that on the screen. It doesn't really matter. Let's hop back into the normal mode. I will go to the Old Town, and then we'll see in the Old Town how much we'll get for the normal for the drop on normal difficulty. So, hear you in just a moment. Okie dokie, we are back on normal difficulty. I grabbed one drop, only one. And we are in Old Town, so let's go, let's stop with Spike. Let's see what we'll get right now. So we've got that many levels, that much experience. And we gained, let's see, 11,000? Do I calculate that right? Something like that. So as you can see, we are getting so much more just by quickly hopping to nightmare difficulty. That is just crazy. Okie dokie, but I haven't really told you what we are doing in today's episode, right? Oh yeah, I haven't told you. So today I would like to prepare for going into Dying Light the following. So the pretty big story DLC for Dying Light, that is very, very cool. I think I prefer the main game, but the following is just amazing also. Because for example, you've got this car that you can get. And from Dying Light the following also, you've got quite a lot of weapons that came to the normal game. So for example, before when you were going with Dying Light, the normal story mode, the only shotgun that you could get was double barrel shotgun. That's as high as you could go. And as you can see from our inventory right now, I think I've got the best possible shotgun that you can get right now. So, semi-automatic shotgun. That was introduced in Dying Light the Following. Crossbow was also introduced in Dying Light the Following. And something else was introduced. I don't really remember what. But generally speaking, Dying Light the Following not only gave us new story, but also quite a lot of new weapons. Okie dokie. But because we would like to prepare for Dying Light the Following, let's talk a little bit about weapons, dockets, and everything concerning that. So you can find weapons all around Haran, or around the old town slums, wherever you want, and so on. But they are scaling with your levels. So, as for example, with your drops, you've got drop that you will, for example, pick up at level 1, and it will give you a certain amount of experience at level 1, right? At level 5, it will give you a different amount of experience. The same is going on with weapons. If you find a weapon at level 1, probably it will be very shitty, because it will be like, I don't know, 50 damage is the best weapon that you can get at level 1, or maybe like 100, something like that. If you go to level 25 survival rank, you can get the best possible weapons, and you cannot just go any higher, if I read that correctly, and I've also seen that happening. So it doesn't really matter how higher you go with legend levels, you cannot go higher than level 25 survivor with your weapons that you can get. Great. But there is also another thing that is very important when it comes to levels and weapons. So with weapons, let me show you that. You've got different rarities of weapons. So we've got the gray, that is the most basic one. You've got green, you've got blue, then you've got purple, you've got orange, and you've got gold. Basically, the gold is the best one. The yellow one is the best one, but it's also the hardest one to get. It also depends on difficulty, as with drops. So for Nightmare difficulty drop that you will give to Quartermaster, you are getting so much experience, right? And for weapons that you are getting at Nightmare difficulty, you are also getting the best possible weapons that you can get. Beautiful, right? So yeah, we've got quite a lot of dockets. If we'll go into our inventory right here, we'll see that I've got 9 Bozak dockets. I believe that can give us golden weapons, but classic dockets, that is, I believe that can give you purple or orange. That is from some kind of event. We'll also take that. That is from event that was Chinese New Year, I believe. Yeah, and we can get a new bow with that. We've got 6 premium dockets that are, those are giving, I believe, gold weapons. That is guaranteed gold weapons. And I believe that is also guaranteed gold weapon. But to, you know, boost our chances even higher, I think that we'll go back to the old slums, to our quartermaster, because then we are just spawning there. Because also another question, another thing that I would like to tell you, if you haven't watched my series and I haven't told you that before, you can fast travel in this game. And I'm not talking about going to the Ember's Tower and fast traveling to slums, or going to slums to the tower and fast traveling to Ember's Tower. So if you've got quest active, game is very nice to you and it wants to help you. So for example, we've got that quest coffee, and that quest will fast travel us to the location that we are supposed to go. So for example, if you've got quest that is happening at the tower, then when you get out of the game and go back, you will go to the tower. If you got quest that is happening at the old town, you will probably spawn at the Ember's Tower. I believe that's the only point that you can go. If you will choose Bozak Horde, you will spawn in Bozak Horde. If you will choose Prison Heist, you will go to Prison Heist. location. There are also few quests that can lead you to Fisherman Village in the slums. So let me quickly hop back to Nightmare difficulty. Let's go back to the slums, to the tower, and then we'll get all of those beautiful dockets. So see you in just a moment. Okie dokie, I am back and we are at Nightmare difficulty. So let's go to our quartermaster and let's get all of those beautiful dockets. So let's see. Let's make go of that bow first. Thank you very much. Let's go with those kings. Amazing. Okie dokie. Let's get all of those kings. Amazing. Okie dokie. Classic docket. Let's see what that will give us. And dark machete. Okay. Special docket. What do we got for that? Fabulous commando knife. Something very shitty. Let's go with Bozak docket. And that gave us a golden weapon. Amazing. And what is premium docket giving us? I believe also golden weapon. Yeah, go to stash. Premium katana. Okie dokie, amazing. I don't have any room in our inventory. That's shitty. Let's see. That is quite a good bow, I think. Let's see, we'll sell that because I don't care about knives. Let's hide those. That is very shitty that we've got. I mean, quite a lot of damage, but not really that great. But we've got premium katana. Well, shit. I thought that we'll get something better. Okay, okay, let's just sell that. Because I don't care about that. And let's sell all of those. All of those flares. Amazing stuff. Okie dokie. So, right now we've got premium katana. That is quite a good weapon. I mean, that one is better, but it's upgraded and so on. I've been running around quite a lot of that one. Do I want to get all of those dockets right now? Screw it. Let's go with Bozak dockets, all of them. Okie dokie. Fabulous button. Amazing. I was trying to get something better. Get the fuck out of those knives. Heavy tribal axe. Okie dokie. Yeah, give me all of those dockets. Get the fuck out of those knives. Okie dokie. Amazing. There is also chance to get tribal axe, to get fantasy weapons that are the rarest one that you can get. Okie dokie, let's look at our inventory. Holy shit, that's quite a lot of damage. We'll sell that. That is quite good. Okie dokie, but I don't really care about weapons that are so low on handling. So let's sell everything that we don't need. Sorry, that this episode will be a little bit of like patchwork. I don't really like it when that we can leave. I don't really like it when episodes look like that because I feel that it's not really good episode then. I think that we'll go with better handling or better damage. I believe that we'll go with that. Okie dokie. I think that we'll go with that military machete, but screw it, we can craft all of them. So let's see. I wish that katana had more damage. God damn it. Okie dokie. So let's grab that one into Angel Sword, of course. Oh. You won't find better deals in all of Haran. I am lacking something. Excuse me. We cannot. Oh, that is knife. I thought that was crooked machete. Oh, okie dokie. That changes my perspective a little bit. Okie dokie. Angel sword, the best one that we can get. And that is already doing quite a lot of damage. Let's also upgrade that to... I believe all kings. I believe all kings is seems like a good one. So let's go. I've got like 5 kings, something like that, so I don't really care if we will use all of them here. King is the best upgrade that we can get. Okay, okay, let's confirm that upgrade. Amazing stuff. And right now we are not leaving that weapon. So with the higher the rarity of the weapons, the more the repairs they have. So as you can see, golden weapons always have 6 repairs. Orange one has have 5 repairs, purple one have 4, and so on and so on. So yeah, amazing. That is in quite a lot of damage. Amazing stuff. Okie dokie. The next thing that I would like to do is to check out those different bows that we can upgrade. We've got sockets for bow. I have never found that out. Okie dokie, let's go with, let's see, Bozak bow. I would like to check out how good that is. Okie dokie, let's see. Holy shit, that's the same as Dragon's Breath. Okay. So probably there is some kind of difference between them. Rate of fire 18. Rate of fire 18, they are just the same. Can craft Bozak bow into Dragon Breath. And that will give us the same damage. Nothing more. Weird, but we can also upgrade. And Bozak bow, we've got 2 places for upgrade. With that, we've got 3. Oh, that is quite a lot of better. Okie dokie. So we might want to invest few kings in that. Okie dokie. Good to know. Okie dokie. So, what else would we like to do? God fucking damn it. For sure not run at night during the nightmare difficulty. Get the fuck back. Okie dokie. There are a few quests that I would like to do. For example, the one with Talia I would like to do. And all of the ones that we've got right now active. Those are the ones that you are giving to Toygar, and you can find them. You can pick them up from that board, and then you are giving it to him. So I will do them, and we'll see how many levels we can get from all those quests. Why will be on the nightmare difficulty? Of course, I will not do those quests at nightmare difficulty, no way. But we'll see how much we can exploit the game with just hopping between difficulties. So give me just one moment, I will grab all the supplies that we need for those quests. Maybe a few more drops, we'll see. So yeah, I will hear you in just a moment. Thank you. Okie dokie, change of plans. I'm not really doing those quests, so screw them. I just went for a little bit of drop hunting. So yeah, right now we are at one of the quarantine zones, and that is the easiest one to grab a lot of drops in relatively short time. So let's see, right now I will try to go only for the drops. I will ignore all the GRE chests and all the other loot. So fuck that all. We need to camouflage a little bit. Okay, okay, so let's see how fast we can collect all the drops that are here without really picking up all of those GRE chests and loot inside them. Okie dokie. Remember that if you want to go here in this location for that drop, better grab that camouflage. It will save you quite a lot of trouble. Okie dokie, let's see. Right now we've got to go right here. Okie dokie, let's see. Where is that sweet spot? Nope, not here. Okie dokie. Oh, fuck. Right here. Nice. Okie dokie, let's go. Another drop is right here. That will be our third one. Okie dokie, beautiful. Let's get the fuck out of here. Okie dokie, they didn't even found out that we are here. Amazing stuff. Not here. Shit. Okie dokie, nice. Let's see, right now we've got to go to the toilet. So let's do it. Jumpscare time. Fuck you. Okie dokie, amazing stuff. And that's it. We've got all the fucking drops. Amazing stuff. Okie dokie, now we can just get the fuck out of here. Beautiful. If I will not get catched on every possible fucking thing that is here, then it would have been much, much faster. But as you can see, you can farm quite a lot of drops here in relatively short time. I don't even know how long that was. But it was like 2 minutes, something like that. You can go, of course, a little bit faster if you will not get caught on every possible little shit that is going on here. But yeah, after you finish up that quarantine zone, that drop is respawning here. There are around 2 or 3 rice soldiers here, so keep that in mind. But that is good way to just, you know, grab another drop almost for free, because killing those guys is just not a problem right now. Okie dokie, beautiful. We can pick up that lock. Oh shit, oh shit. Get the fuck out of here. Beautiful. And let's go back to that quarantine zone. And you can just stay right here. Before, the clip that I showed you were all the drops that I catch just running around the city. I had a little bit of a problem with that because those drops weren't really spawning here. Okie dokie. Let's go back here. Those drops weren't really spawning in. I slept like 3 in the in-game days. And they still weren't really showing up. That was very fucking weird. But screw it. After I went to that quarantine zone, everything was just back to normal. Okie dokie, beautiful. Let's see, we want to grab the camouflage right now. Beautiful. Let's get the fuck out of here. Don't step into that electricity. That would suck. That's for sure. Okie dokie, let's go. Okie dokie, amazing stuff. Kill that shite, although it's not necessary, but I just like to do it. Killing children. No, we are just... God damn it! What is the game saying when we are getting close to them? God fucking damn it! I forgot what the game was trying to say to us. Where we are trying to... God fucking damn it! We are not killing them in theory, because killing children in game would be quite shitty. Because of that, many game developers are just not, you know, putting children as enemies in the game. But in here we are for sure doing something with children. It is very shitty. Oh, Jackie, beautiful. I believe that will calm them down, something like that. Okie dokie, let's get the fuck out of here. Okie dokie, so that's generally speaking it for this quarantine zone. We are just going back and forth. And nothing really too complicated is going on. And you can get 5 drops in like 2 minutes, something like that. So that's pretty easy, right? Okie dokie, so I think that right now I would like to go back to Nightmare difficulty after we'll kill those Rice soldiers that will just respawn here. Okie dokie. Oh, 4 guys! I don't remember when I last saw 4 guys here. I think I never saw 4 guys here. Okie dokie. Let's see. Let's hide. Beautiful. Let's grab all of that loot. Killing those guys is also very nice because you can get quite a lot of weapons that maybe not are the best for, you know, fighting and so on, but they are very good for selling. You can get so much money just for selling those weapons. Oh yeah. That's one of the golden rules of the video games. Loot everything that you can. And that will make you rich. And it doesn't really matter which game you are playing. Stalker, Dying Light, The Last of Us, Bioshock, whatever. It doesn't really matter. Loot everything that you can. And that will make you rich and that will make your game quite a lot easier, right? Okay, okay. So let me fall down, I guess. Okie dokie. Beautiful. Let me travel back to the old town and I will hop back to Nightmare difficulty so we'll get all of those drops delivered in Nightmare difficulty. And after that we'll check out Dahlia because I believe that we've got still 3 quests that we can do for her. We'll see. So, hear you in just a moment. Okie dokie, I am back and as you can see we are at Nightmare difficulty. Let's see, because I was running around I managed to get one other agility level, so let's just distribute that wherever we want. Okie dokie, let's see how many drops we have. 29, okie dokie. And we are almost at the next level. So yeah, let's go.
Thanks for the surprise. So you beat Rice to the airdrop, huh?
Yep.
That's impressive.
Okie dokie, beautiful. And we are already at level 15. Amazing stuff. I would like to get 1 point in. I believe in. We cannot go with that really. We've got required level for that. Okay, we can go with bow. That might be interesting, so let's go with one here. Let's see. Health regen, more health. Stamina, throwing. Don't really care, an art, don't really care. Maybe let's go with health regen, and generally speaking, just more health. Okie dokie. Beautiful, but also we got legendary level, but we can also get 1 more quest. So let's see, because we've got enough coffee for that. So let's see what we'll get for that.
Nice of you to drop it.
You are a lifesaver. Those coffee nuts are dangerous. They're basically volatiles that can talk, and they only talk about one thing.
Okay, okay, I gave him something. I don't really know what. It doesn't really matter. He gave us something. A little bit of experience, but screw it. Okie dokie. So let me hop back to normal difficulty and I will meet you when we'll be at location where Dahlia is, because I think that we can already activate her quests. So see you in just a moment. Okie dokie, I am back. We are back at normal difficulty. And a little reminder, if you don't really know why we are going to Dahlia, let's repair that fucking weapon. Okey-dokey. She gave us a quest to go to one of the caves in this location, and we had to pick a few mushrooms, and that gave us ability to create Dahlia shrimp potion, something like that. That should shield us from the eyes of infected. And it's amazing and so on. It's working. They cannot see us, but there is weird side effect to that. That we are walking very weird. Right now it's working. Okay, that's beautiful. But they cannot see us.
What's wrong with me?
Oh yeah. Now it's going bad. Now it's fucking bad. Oh shit. Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, that is fucking bad.
Maybe a stronger elixir would have fewer side effects.
Yeah, okie dokie, so I had to cram that too in order to grab that quest. Okie dokie. So as you can see, it was working quite well. Other than that, we are walking every fucking where. So let's talk with her, because something is for sure wrong with that potion.
So, you are ready to try a more powerful elixir? It will make you more useful to me. But it will require agents of greater potency.
Just tell me what you need, Dahlia.
Bring me the liver of a powerful Immortui. It must be a giant of great physical strength. Return when you have what I need.
What? Ghouls.
You should watch yourself.
Oh shit, where can we find ghouls? Well, for sure there will be in the old town. But is there a location in here where they can spawn? In slums. Like, guaranteed spawn. God fucking damn it, I don't really know. Let's think about it really, really quickly. Is there a location where you've got guaranteed spawn of goon in slums? I don't think so. Okie dokie. I think that the easiest one to do is to go to the old town really, really quickly. Okie dokie. So, I will not bore you with that. I will just go there and I will be back when I will, you know, kill that goon. So, see you in just a moment. Okie dokie, I am back. I've got that putrescent liver. So let's right now go back to Dahlia. And let's hope that this potion will be a little bit better. Because, yeah, I'm counting on that potion. Because if you get the best potion that she can brew, then you've got quite a lot of easier time in prison heist, and that is something that I would like to check out, that's for sure. Okie dokie, back to Dahlia we go. Good thing that she's very close to the tower. Okie dokie, let's see. Here you are, let's go.
Yes, that's it. Let me see it. What terrible strength this creature wields. Perfect. Consuming this elixir may have consequences. Then again, it may not. If you think your system can endure more powerful agents, I can produce elixirs of still greater potency. I will summon you again when the time comes.
Okie dokie, when the time comes. So probably got to use that potion right now. Let's see, we've got that liver potion, let's go. What will that do? Okie dokie. So far it's quite good. It is making us slower? Do I see that right?
What the fuck?
What the fuck? Look how slow we are. Holy shit, imagine walking into the crowd of zombies with that. That would be just pure death. Holy shit. Okay, we are good.
Well, it almost worked. Maybe I should let Dahlia try again.
Or maybe you shouldn't. I don't think that it's working out quite good for you, but screw it. Let's talk with her again.
I call and you come. And so quickly now. You are developing very nicely for me. You are ready to endure more powerful elixirs?
I'll take all the edge I can get. Now tell me what you need.
My elixirs affect the mind of the Immortui. And what is in the mind is first in the blood. So I must have what is in their blood. Bring me the kidney from the erupting one that sacrifices its body in attack.
Oh shit. Okay, where we can find exploding guys? This is a very good question. Bomber kidney. Oh fuck. He was in one of the quarantine zones, if I remember that correctly. God fucking damn, but in which one exactly? You can also find them randomly spawning in slums in Old Town, but... Fuck. Okie dokie, let me remember in which quarantine zone we can find bombers. And we'll just quickly go there, right? So give me just one moment. Okie dokie, I am back. And first of all, let's go back to Fort Jefferson. Because from what I heard, you can find something cool in here. At least that's what someone told me. Let's see, we cannot go anywhere here, that's for sure. What's going on here? Well, that's where the explosion happened and so on. That's the body of Jeff. And we've got double barrel shotgun. Amazing. Okie dokie, so it was worth going back here. Amazing stuff. What the game was trying to tell us? Use? What? Exactly for what that was? Use for bucket? Okie dokie, I don't really fucking know. Okie dokie, I'm back because we don't really need to go to any sort of quarantine zone. Because something very interesting showed up on our map. If you will take a look at that, you will see that we've got bomber infested area. We've got also one here. And let's see, was there anything else on the map? And only those two areas, as you can see. Probably there are a few more around the old town, I guess. Okay, let's grab that car trap. Okay, let's check out that bomber infested area. Because I haven't seen that before. And I'm very, very interested in what's going on with that. Okay, for sure we have quite a lot of bombers and so on, right? Let's see. Oh, is that? Let's see. Fuck. Okay, we've got to go in this area. Okay. Oh, you are very annoying. You know that, right? Thank you very much. Okay, let's check out this area then. What we can find here? So far, not too many bombers, really. I was expecting a little bit bombers in the bomber-infested area, but okay. Hello? Excuse me, no bombers? Oh, we've got one right there. Beautiful. So let's loot him and let's get the fuck out of here. Okie dokie, so right now back to Dahlia. Beautiful. Let's get the fuck out of here. Amazing stuff. Okie dokie, so it wasn't that hard. And I think that the last ingredient that we'll need is bolter, liver. I believe that's the case. But we'll see that in just a moment. Let's go right now straight back to Dahlia. And let's see what she will tell us right now. And what will be going on with that potion. Because from what we've seen before, it is quite weird what those potions are doing with us. And yeah, for sure they are working with the infested, the infected. Oh, hello. How are you doing? And the infected cannot see us, but there are also side effects that are very shitty. So let's give her that bomber kidney.
Once more, you have done my bidding. Give it to me. There, it is ready. Take it. My power grows as you become useful, and I can create mixtures of even greater potency. When you are ready, I will create them for you.
Okie dokie, amazing. Kidney punch. Oh, that seems like something I don't want to drink, but alright. Let's see, let's go to our standard testing zone. And let's see what that will do to us. And we can work, we can run, we can jump, we can swing our weapon. Amazing. But let's see what will happen when we go out. And that effect will go out. Okie dokie, so far everything. Holy
shit. This isn't good. This is not good at all.
Oh shit. Holy shit, that is really, really bad. Oh fuck, that is a weird way to walk. In one of the events, I forgot which ones that were. I believe Halloween community event. You were able to pick up.
Give her one more chance.
You were able to pick up different potions that were giving you all sorts of different side effects, and one of them was looking exactly like that. Okie dokie. Let's go. One more chance for Dahlia. Let's go.
I merely will your presence, and you are here within minutes. Perfect.
Dahlia, the elixirs are working, but I need one with no side effects.
And you shall have it. But how quickly you have adapted. This would not be possible if you had not already been bitten. You are closer to them than you think.
I'm taking care of it.
With your antizen. Such a feeble mixture.
Just tell me what I need to bring you.
I will put my thought into your mind.
You don't control me, Dahlia.
No, of course. I am just a foolish old woman. Now think, and tell me what you believe I will need.
Look, it's not hard to guess. Your distillations affect the pattern recognition processes of the Immortui. So, now I assume you'll want a brain. Probably from one of the stronger ones.
Yes?
From a bolter.
And you simply guessed this? Well, if it gives you some comfort, so be it. Now go. Return when you have what I need.
I wouldn't say that a bolter is...
The brain of a bolter!
What?
Excellent! Take it. It is the most powerful elixir I can make for you.
That wasn't brain of the bolter. That was just a fucking bolter tissue. What the fuck? Bring the brain of Usain Bolter. Okie dokie, what the fuck was that supposed to be? So right now we've got a cloak potion, and I believe that's the one that is without any side effects. So let's check that out. And... Okie dokie, how long that will last? Okie dokie, so far very good.
I think we've got a winner.
Yeah, it seems like that's the case. Okie dokie, that's not very long lasting really, but it's good enough, I think. Okie dokie. Let's see, I would like to show you something else, but I think I might have to Google that in order to to get that. Yeah. There are two things that I would like to show you. Okie dokie. So give me just one moment. I will prepare for that and then I will come back to you. Okie dokie. I am back and what I would like to show you is something very interesting. So let's see, right here we've got two hard chests and in here we should have quite a good loot, right? Because it's hard difficulty and so on. But we are not taking anything from here because from what I heard, the loot that you can pick up from those different chests, if you will not pick it up, it will just respawn here as something else. So that's something very interesting I would like to see. So as you can see right here we've got Dark Sickle and Jewel Box. And let's see, Green Piece and Pouch. So right now I would like to see where we've got the nearest save zone. Up there. Fuck, that was Bomber. Okay, let's go over here then. Let's climb up. Let's see. And I would like to just check out how it will look like during the night. What will happen right then? Because from those hard difficulty chests you can get legendary weapons. No, I don't want a deal. I want to sleep. Oh, right here. Okie dokie, so let's check out how that chest will look like during night. Let's see, okay, and we've got our marker there. I would like to see something. Get the fuck out of here with Beat a Zombie. I don't fucking care. Okie dokie, maybe it would be also wise to check out that potion that we just created. Cloak potion. We need border tissue for that. Okie dokie, so that is good excuse for farming border tissue. But we got 5 of them. Oh, that's very interesting. Okie dokie, but of course right now there will be volatiles running around. So we don't want to alarm them, that's for sure. Fuck, go up, go up. Okie dokie, let's see. And we've got to lockpick those again. Oh shit, and we've got volatile right next to us. Holy fucking shit. Okie dokie, but during the night we should have better chances of getting cool weapons. I think I heard that right. Okie dokie, so let's see. Okie dokie. Shit, that water is very close. A little bit too close, in my opinion. Okie dokie. Yeah, it's kinda looking better, right? Fuck, let's get out of here. Okie dokie, and in theory, if we will take a little walk around the place and come back to that location. Holy shit, it was very close. A little bit too close. Let's see. So right now, in theory, if we'll go back to this location. Oh, help. Beautiful. If we'll go back to this location, maybe not to the quarantine zone, that would suck. Oh, for fuck's sake. Okie dokie. Let's see. Okie dokie, beautiful. Hello zombies, how are you doing? Fuck. Fuck. Oh, for fuck's sake. Let's get the fuck out of here. Up we go, thank you very much. Kiedelki. That sucked. Hello guys, how are you doing? Volatiles can still get to us. Let's see. Kiedelki, amazing stuff. Get the fuck out of here. Yeah, probably shooting them is not the wisest idea, but screw it. They will lose interest in us in just a moment. Reactivate that car trap. Okay, okay, are they coming for us? Oh, fuck, 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 fuck. Okay, okay, they can also speed at us. Beautiful. Yeah, we can farm a few levels with that method, that's for sure. Okie dokie. Funny thing is that they don't really take fall damage. So that's something worth noting. Okie dokie. But right now we should lose pursuit, if I remember correctly. Yeah, nice. Okie dokie. Fuck. They are still running around. Okie dokie. Let's see, let's go right here. Okie dokie, let's quickly go back where we should. Fuck. Oh fuck. Okay, maybe let's use that cloak potion right now. Beautiful. Okie dokie. So it's not really looking that great. God fucking damn it. So what will happen right now if we'll change our difficulty to Nightmare? I don't really like running at Nightmare at night. But screw it, we'll do it for the sake of science, I guess. We've got those cloak potions, so we should be alright. Okie dokie, so give me just one moment and we'll check out what we can do. What the fuck? Okie dokie, that was weird. We'll see what we can do during the night with those two chests. So give me just one moment. Okie dokie, I am back. It's, as you can see, pure night. We are also at nightmare level. I don't like to do it, but screw it. For the sake of science, I guess, let's fucking do it. I don't know even the good way of going down right now. Because I don't want to alarm every possible zombie out there. I think it would be wisest to go here. Let's see, and I don't see any volatiles around. What the fuck? Oh, they are not showing on the minimap. Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, let's drink that potion very, very fast. Oh, for fuck's sake. Okie dokie, one of those hard chests is gone. Interesting. Okie dokie, shit. Let's do it rather quickly. Fuck, fuck. Fuck. For fuck's sake, where the fuck is that sweet spot? Oh, we'll fucking die. Okie dokie, amazing stuff. Let's see what we'll get. Okie dokie, I was expecting a little bit better. So someone told me that it's the best possible way to get fantasy weapons. Okie dokie, I guess let's run for it. So yeah, not really that good of a way, I think. I think it would be easier to just go with quarantine zones. Especially the one that I showed you before. So yeah, let's check that out, so give me just one moment. Okie dokie, I am back. Right now we're at difficulty Nightmare, as you can see, and we are doing that quarantine zone. So in theory, that is the, I think at least that's the best quarantine zone to grab all of those, not only to grab those drops, but there are also 4 GRE chests that we can get. So let's see how shitty that will be. Because I never played on Nightmare difficulty with quarantine zones. Okay, we are still killing them quite fast. Oh, not really. Okay, so yeah, of course they have got much better statistic right now, better health and so on. Okay, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. Okay, beautiful. Beautiful. Okay, let's finish it up. Let's kill you also. Beautiful. Okay, let's hide from all of those zombies. Let's see. So now in theory, because we've got Nightmare difficulty, we should be getting quite a lot of good weapons from those GRE chests. Not really. God fucking damn it. Okay, because there is like no really good way of farming those legendary items. I'm looking only for fantasy weapons, because those are the rarest one. So I believe, let's see, let's grab that camouflage right now. I believe if I read that right, that at Nightmare difficulty you've got 1 in 100 chance of getting fantasy weapon. If you can get a golden weapon, that is. On hard difficulty that's 1 in 1000. And you remember it is possible on normal difficulty. So yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, let's see another chest. Okay, but so far it's not looking too good. It's not really looking too good. Let's see, where the fuck is that sweet spot? Fuck. Okay. Beautiful, and what can you find inside? Boomerang blade. Not really that good. I was expecting a little bit better, being honest. But screw it. Let's see, we got 2 more chests in here. Maybe we'll have better luck with those. Maybe I just have to read a little bit more about that subject. God damn it. Okay. Of course, getting dockets and so on is quite a good way to get legendary weapons. Especially farming at Bozak Horde. That's for sure. God fucking damn it. Where the hell is that sweet spot? Right on the left. Amazing. Okay, let's see. Fabulous pickaxe. I would prefer, you know, nice legendary weapon. Okay. Let's see. There are also a few challenges that can give you legendary weapons. So maybe it would be wiser to just check them out. I don't really know. Let's take that. Okay. Amazing. Let's go. Let's get the fuck out. Let's see. Let's grab that one. I don't think there are any more GRE chests that we can get, if I remember that correctly. So let's go with that jump scare right here. Fuck you. Beautiful. Okay. Let's get out. Okay, fuck you all, guys. I'm getting out of here. Okay, I was really expecting that we'll find some kind of legendary fantasy weapon in here. God fucking damn it. But maybe I just have to run a little bit more on Nightmare difficulty for that. Okay, but I don't want to bore you with that, because that will be just way too shitty. This episode is also looking pretty shitty, because there is quite a lot of little clips that I will have to later put together, where I will have to catalog and social and so on. And I don't really like to do it, because that seems like That's like a very shitty way to do episodes, because when you've got normal 1 hour long episode, I can talk to you about all sorts of stuff. And there is quite a lot of stuff that I can tell you. And, you know, when I have one thought that I would like to tell you about, then, you know, I have full 1 hour to do it and so on. But when we've got only like those little clips, I don't feel like it's worth going back and forth and going on with the same idea, the same topic and so on. And also it feels just generally weird to do those little clips. But I didn't think that that episode would look anything better if I would just run around the whole town without any cuts. That would be just way too shitty and way too long. Let's deliver those drops. Let's see, we are at that much experience.
Thanks, great job. You'll make good use of
this. For sure. Okie dokie, amazing stuff. Okie dokie, let's see, we got another legend level, beautiful. Maybe let's put that to good use with health regeneration, beautiful. Okie dokie, let me hop back. Screw it. Okay, maybe I will show you something else. Give me just one moment.
If you're headed across town, I'm headed that way too.
Let me hear what you got.
I need to get somewhere. You don't need to know how or why. I just need your help getting there and to protect me while I grab some things. Would you help me? I'm not careful, I'm asking. You up for some hard work?
Yeah, we are up for some hard work. That is the guy that was trying to find. Okay, not really. I was trying to find different one, but screw it. I wanted to find Blue Shield Survivor, because they are very special. So let's go in here.
Okay, we move fast and we don't waste time looking for things if they aren't there. Understood?
Okay, so let's go, let's protect him. It is very, very important thing to find that blue shield, because they are giving you quite a cool stuff.
You just need a few seconds. That it is. Not bad.
Of course, we've got toads. Oh, for fuck's sake. Okie dokie. Actually, what you are looking at is...
Love what you're doing, but I should move on.
What you're seeing right now is part of the next episode. Well, I'm recording that in the middle of recording the next episode. So, god fucking damn it, that was weird. But screw it. We can do it without any problems. Because I want to show you what that blue shield is doing. Because that is amazing. And they are not really that... oh, hello guys. They aren't really that common to find. So yeah, that's pretty amazing that I found one. Okie dokie, amazing. Let's protect the survivor. Okie dokie, let's see. Beautiful. Okie dokie, amazing stuff. How is his health? Okay, he's right here. He's helping us a little bit. Okay, we've got to repair that weapon. Okie, let's fucking go. Okie, beautiful. Let's heal up a little bit. Oh shit. Okie, beautiful. One more. Amazing stuff. Okay, let's keep moving then. Holy shit, that's quite a lot of enemies. Okay, let's just fucking go. Okay, let's protect him as good as we can. Okay, let's just fucking move. Okay. Yeah, full steam ahead. Come on. Let's finish that. We are taking a nice scenery look at the wall around the harem. Fuck. Of course he's walking straight into groups of zombies. Amazing stuff. I'd prefer you not to take that risk, but screw it.
Come on.
Come on. Okie dokie, beautiful. Okie dokie. Oh, come on, just kill him. Look, that's easy. Okie dokie, get the fuck out of here. Thank you very much. Can you move a little bit faster? Okie dokie, so let's keep moving then. Okie dokie, come on. You got something around there. I think that's toad. Okie dokie. Let's continue. Okie dokie, let's go. Beautiful, let's heal up. Beautiful, can we continue? Pick up those goddamn, I don't know. Don't you worry about that. Collect those, I don't know, leaves, berries, roots. What the fuck are you even collecting? Okie dokie. So blue shield missions are a little bit harder than the normal white ones, but screw it. It is fucking worth it. It doesn't matter that we are using quite a lot of our durability of the weapons, because it will be worth it in the long run. Okie dokie, let's go. Okie dokie, I don't see any more zombies. At least right now. Okie dokie, I see already more zombies. Let's not get too far from him. Okie dokie. Of course. Oh, fucking course. Okie dokie, beautiful. Let's go. Yeah, full steam ahead. Can you just fucking move? Okie dokie, beautiful. Someone else? Oh, yeah, so many fucking zombies. Like they are just normal biters, but still. Very annoying. Fuck. Fuck. Okie dokie, managed to do it. Okie dokie, come on. We are moving out of here. The bigger they are, the harder they smash you. Yeah, for sure. The harder they smash you. Oh, can we just fucking move? Okie dokie. Okie dokie. Let's see. Got fucking viral coming, or not really. Can you just fucking move? Come on, it's getting dark. Are we done yet? Okie dokie, and we are not done yet. God fucking damn it. Come on. Okie dokie. How many more zombies there are waiting for us? Don't tell me that we'll be doing that at night. Don't tell me that we'll be doing that at fucking night. Okay, he's at half the health. Oh, for fuck's sake. Move faster. Of course, we got fucking virals everywhere. Okie dokie, let's move. Let's fucking move. It's really, really late. I don't want to protect you from volatiles. That would be very shitty. Oh, just move fucking faster. Oh no, don't tell me he'll be fighting with that demolisher that is over there. Oh no, that will make quite a lot of noise. Come on, come on. Pick that up. What time is it? Oh, we are very close tonight. Are we done? Not really. Not fucking really. Oh shit. Oh, that might be very shitty. Okie dokie, beautiful. That might have been a very shitty idea, but that might lure them away from him. So that's pretty amazing. Oh shit, the night is coming. Yeah. Just fucking move. Oh shit. It's night. Oh shit. I wasn't expecting that to happen. Okay, okay, are we fucking done? And
nice working with you. You earned your cut, so here it is. Maybe we'll do this again sometime.
Okie dokie. So we can go either with rewards or refurbished weapons. So that's what we would like to do. So you can fully repair your weapon. And I mean all the repairs, all the durability and so on. Look at that. Accept that. Yep. Look at that. We are back at 6 uses and 98 durability. It's just fucking amazing. And nothing else that we can do. We can also grab all of those rewards, I believe. Okie dokie. And he's just staying here. Amazing. Okie dokie. Let me go back to recording this video. I mean the next episode. And well, if you will see that in the next clip I have destroyed Machete a little bit, you know why. I'm recording that after recording that previous episode. God fucking damn it. Okie dokie, but then the look from here is quite cool. I've got to admit that. Although textures are not really looking that good. But still, quite a cool look. Okie dokie. So, I will leave you back with the episode.
Thank you for saving my son.
I'm really sorry I couldn't save his father.
I could not save him either. He was a stubborn man. Not a bad man, but he could not see things any way but his own. There's a lot of that out there.
Dawood wanted him to have this. Could you give it to Sammy and tell him it's from his dad?
You are a good man, Mr. Crane. Thank you.
Good luck, Salma.
Okie dokie, I am back with the last thing that I would like to show you, and that is the best possible way or place to farm power levels. At least that's what I think it is. So let's see. First of all, I would like to craft one thing, because from one of the community events gave us opportunity to create this ox cannon. So I would like to go with that. I don't want to waste our beautiful engraved semi-automatic shotgun, so let's just go with that shitty double barrel shotgun. Let's see, and we'll see how much damage that will do right now. Let's see. That one is doing the same amount of damage. Weird. Okay, okay, also we'll check out different bows, what we can do with them. So let's see. Okie dokie. So let's see. First we are going with the normal bow. Shit. Okie dokie, let's see. That is normal bow. That was pretty shitty. Okie dokie, you are standing still. That's pretty shitty. That is doing 356 damage. That one is doing a little bit over 500. Let's see. That one is still not one hit kill. Okie dokie, we've got. So that is Bozak Bow. We also got Dragon's Breath. And that is the one that we got from one community event. Oh, that one shot killed him. Not that, but those smaller ones we can, I mean weaker ones we can go with one shot kill. Almost. Okie dokie. Pretty weird. I thought that it would be like guaranteed one shot kill. Weird. Okay, let's see. Oh, that is only one shot. Holy shit, that is very powerful. Okie dokie, now they are turning to those weird vitals. Okie dokie. And you can kinda see why that location is just goddamn amazing when it comes to farming. Because if you just step right here, then you are in safe zone. If you step out, then you are in the normal world during night, when you've got double the points and so on. Okie dokie. But we already see that those bows aren't really that good. So I think that I will just stick with everything else that we've got. But maybe that ox cannon isn't really that bad. Hello. Yeah, it's going quite well. It's also quite good when you've got volatiles here. Then you can take them out pretty easily. Let's see. Let's go. Okie dokie, amazing. And just speaking, that location is just the best one for farming power levels. When I wasn't really at the legend level yet, I was coming here constantly to farm those levels. Beautiful. And sometimes there are volatiles coming here. So that is giving you even more experience. Okie dokie. Beautiful. Okie dokie. And there's quite a lot of loot that is that you can get here. Okie dokie. Beautiful. And there's also quite a lot of zombies dying over there, so that's also amazing. Hello, how are you doing? Beautiful. Okie dokie, we're at perfect level 3. I believe at level 4 we are getting hazmat suits that are running around, if I remember that correctly. So that's something that I would like to see. And Pierce activated. God fucking damn it, I thought that we'll be able to run a little bit longer with those zombies. We didn't have really any volatile coming our way. That's pretty shitty. Well, let's see, we've got firecrackers, maybe we can lure someone here. Volatiles? Yeah, there is one coming. Somewhere around here. I don't think that it will be able to maneuver through those, through all of that electricity. No, it just despawned. Oh, not really. Okie dokie. It is showing up and dying? Is it dying? Weird. Okie dokie, but as you can see, you got quite a lot of loot here. Also, there are zombies just dying. As you can see right there, for example, there are a lot of those loot boxes that we are getting from zombies. God fucking damn it. Where are volatiles? We've got virus. I wanted something better. Okie dokie, come on. Come on, give me some volatiles. Okie dokie, hello. Beautiful. Come on, give me volatiles. Beautiful. Amazing stuff. Oh shit, we've got volatile. Oh shit, that's why this location is amazing. We can just go here and hide. Beautiful. Yeah, come for me. Okie dokie, beautiful. We can just stand here and constantly shoot them. Beautiful. If we'll be able to reload, then that might be a little bit easier. Beautiful. Quite a lot of nightwalkers, I believe they are called. parts of the biters that are transforming into zombies. Shit, but we are running out of shotgun ammo. Shotgun is just the best option for killing them. But nope. And we are out of ammo for that. But we got still that rifle. Take them out like that. Beautiful. Come on, give me some more volatiles. Okie dokie. Come on. Come on. Beautiful. But no more volatiles. Usually I have like 10 of them around here. Very fucking weird. Okie dokie, but that will be it for this episode. We did quite a lot of cool stuff and so on. Oh, there is volatile spawning, but I think he's dying somewhere on that electricity. I think. But I might be wrong about it. But as you can see, you can get quite a lot of loot in here, quite a lot of experience and so on. Especially that location is useful when you are still not really too high level on strength. Because you are mainly getting strength from here. Yeah. But that will be it for this episode. I would like to thank you all for watching. And of course, see you in the next one. Bye bye.